നാൽപ്പത്തിരണ്ടാം സങ്കീർത്തനം നമുക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും വായിക്കാം. സാംസ് 42. As the deer pants for the water brooks, so pants my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my food all day and night, while they continually say to me, Where is your God? When I remember these things, I pour out my soul within me, for I used to go with the multitude. I went with them to the house of God with the voice of joy and praise, with a multitude that kept a pilgrim fest. Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquiet within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him for the help of his countenance. O my God, my soul is cast down within me. Therefore, I will remember you from the land of Jordan and from the heights of Hermon, from the hill Mizar. Deep calls unto deep at the noise of your waterfalls. All your waves and billows have gone over me. The Lord will command his loving kindness in the daytime, and in the night his song shall be with me, a prayer to the God of my life. I will say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why do I go mourning because of the oppression of the enemy? As with the breaking of my bones, my enemies reproach me, while they say to me all day long, Where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. Praise the Lord. I thank God for this wonderful opportunity God has given me to stand before all of you with the word of God. I have never spoken from Psalms before, but Neville told me this is how Pastor Uncle likes to welcome all the new members to church. So I am very excited. All right. So I would just like to start with a small story. So a mother is trying to take her daughter to the doctor for a vaccine shot. So she knows the daughter is very afraid of injections, as all kids are. And the mother knows that very well. But yet one day she is preparing her to take her to the doctor anyway. And the daughter thinks in her heart, I don't think she's taking me to the doctor, because she knows very well I hate injections and I'm very afraid of that. And so she hopes that she's going somewhere else, somewhere nice. But then only the mother knows that we're actually going to the doctors, and they end up there. And this girl is thinking, what kind of a mother is she? Today morning she woke me up, she fed me, and she seemed very nice. But then even though she knows I'm afraid of injections, she's taking me to the doctor to get an injection. And so this is like a big problem in the child's life. And so she's observing, not only is the mother very keen on giving her her injections, she's also paying the doctor so that he does not miss. So this girl can't understand what's going on, and this is a big problem that is happening in her life. So we'll come back to this story a bit later. Okay, so in this Psalms, the premise is that there's a lot of distress in the psalmist's life. So this psalm is written by the sons of Korah, and the premise of the psalm is like yearning for God in the midst of distress. So that's the premise. And when we look at verse number 3, my tears have been my food all day and night, while they continually say to me, where is your God? And also verse number 6, it says, Oh my God, my soul is cast down within me. So it's a very clear picture that the psalmist is putting over here, that there's a lot of distress and anxiety that is going on in his life. So I just want us to just kind of reflect on our lives as well. And this is something that none of us like, is challenges or tough situations or problems coming in our life. None of us want that. We all want a smooth life, a happy, happy life with no troubles, no adverse circumstances, everything to be very plain. We all love that, don't we? But adverse circumstances do come, and we're going to see how the psalmist is overcoming all these situations. All right, so the first thing that he does is verse number 4. He says, when I remember these things, I pour out my soul within me. So the first step that we ought to do is remember the past. Remember what God has done for us in the past. Because I'm sure in everyone's life, there is some past that God has led us through, some difficulty that God has led us through, and situations that we thought was not possible to overcome, but through God, it was very possible. So the most of the times we often forget that these circumstances ever happened in our lives. So the first thing that we need to do is to reflect on our past and see where in my past life, how has God led me through these circumstances? And this brings us quite a few benefits. Like first thing, you learn a few things about God and you reassure yourself a few things about God. In verse number 8, we see the psalmist says, the Lord will command his loving kindness in the daytime. So he is acknowledging the loving kindness of God. So by remembering his past, he acknowledges that God is a loving and kind God, and that God has shown his love towards him in the past. So that's what we can also understand when we look at situations that God has led us in the past. And this is the same God who did not spare his only son on the cross for us to save our souls. So wouldn't he do everything else for us? So he's done the biggest thing that he could ever do. The rest, all that is negligible. Whatever happens in our life is all negligible compared to the biggest sacrifice that God has ever made. So if he has done the big thing, won't he do the small thing? So that is verse number 8. And verse number 9, the psalmist says, I will say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? So, even though there is problems coming in the psalmist's life, he says, I will say to God, my rock. So he knows that God is his rock. So when he brings the problems in front of God, when he is praying, or when he is when he is thinking all these things, one thing he knows for certain is God is his rock. And that he premises over here before saying his problems. So we also often forget that God is our rock. Okay, that is the biggest thing that we have to always keep in mind. We always think about the problems and make those the biggest things in our lives, but we always forget that God is always been our rock. So this is the second thing that happens when we turn back and look at our past, how God has amazingly led us. And we can reassure ourselves, oh yes, God has always been my rock and he is my rock. And that is why I'm going to take all my problems to him and he is going to come through for us. And verse 11, it says, why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. So hope in God, that is a big thing that we always tend to forget. Because think of it, what is the difference between us and the people who don't know God? Both have problems in our lives. Everybody faces situations, but we have hope in God and they do not. So if we forget the fact that our hope is in God and that God is our rock, then there is nothing differentiating us between us and the worldly people who don't know the God. So I would say that would be the biggest dishonor that we're doing to God. After God has done so much for us, we are forgetting that, our hope should be our God, who the maker of heaven and earth. So, and the next thing the psalmist says is, yet I shall praise him. So in every situation that happens, when your hope is in God, then the next step is to always praise him. Thank God for the situation. You know why? Because the word says, for all things work for good for those who love him. So whatever situations happen, whatever troubles come in our lives, that is not because God loves giving troubles in our lives. It is because God has an ulterior motive, is to make us stronger. If we don't face situations and troubles in our lives, we will never know how amazing God can be in our lives. What God can do, what miracles that God can do in our lives if we don't have a situation where we need a miracle. So that is something that we always have to have in our lives. So God gives us certain circumstances, certain situations in our lives just to make us strong, just to make sure that we hold on to hope, we hold on to faith, and we increase our relationship with God stronger and stronger each day, so that when tougher situations come in our lives, we can look back at our past and we can say, oh yeah, God has led me amazingly in the past, and he is able to do that in the future. So even when David, he was faced with a giant, David said, I don't know how to fight him, but all I know is in the one day when I was feeding my sheep, a bear came and attacked and I killed the bear. And another day, a lion came and I killed the lion with my bare hands. So that he can hold on to from his past experiences. If the lion and the bear hadn't come in his life, he wouldn't have been able to stand strong when that situation came where he had to face Goliath. So, but at that time, when the bear came, I'm sure he must have thought, there are so many other shepherds out there. Why does the bear always come to me? You know, there are so many other shepherds who are so reckless. I love my sheep. I take good care of my sheep. Yet the bear came and attacked my sheep. So at that time, he would have thought that. But when the time came, when he actually had to look back on his experiences, that is what pulled him through. And that is what brought him in faith. And that is where he could say, oh no, my God is going to get me through this because of my past experiences where God has always been faithful to me. So coming back to my story. So this girl is now faced with a lot of problems and she doesn't understand why things are happening. And she gets the flu shot anyway because the mother is very adamant and already paid the doctor well. Then what happens is a year later, there's an epidemic in the village. And everybody gets infected but the girl. And that is when she realizes, oh yeah, what my mom did last year, even though I had, at that time, I couldn't understand why that was happening. It was so painful and it didn't make sense at all. But now it totally makes sense. Because we read in the word, for all things work for good for those who love God. And if we love God, everything, every circumstances that happens in our lives, every situation that we face, always works out for good. Because what does Jeremiah say? For God says, for I know the plans that I have for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you. So God's plans are always to prosper us. God's plans are always to give us a hope, give us a future, never to harm us. So we should believe that. And sometimes like when adverse circumstances come, no matter how strong of a believer we are, no matter how what situations we have gone through, we falter and we forget everything in a flash. And that happens to all of us. And during that time, I guess that is the time when we need to pause and think and reassure ourselves of who our God really is and how he has come through for us in the past and believe that God is going to do that for us in the future as well. And whatever situations we are facing, we have to hold on to faith and hold on to that hope that is Christ our rock. So the main thing I guess over here is let's never lose hope in the midst of adverse circumstances. And whatever happens in our lives, always we need to believe that, yeah, this has happened with the knowledge of God. And this is always going to bring a positive result in my spiritual life so that I might look back at this situation one day and I'll be like, yes, because this happened in my life, now I can say for sure that whatever comes ahead, I can face that with very strong motives. I guess that's all I wanted to say from this psalm. It's a very short thought and a very short thinking that God had put in my heart and I wanted to share with all of you. And may God bless you with these words. Thank you.